to our YouTube channel, Dora the Enviata. So Enviata, I wanted to show you guys how to make a shaggy mat for that case. Shaggy mat. By saying shaggy mat, I mean a mat which looks like this. It's very soft. So if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe. Click on the notification bell button so that you get notification anytime we post. And for those who have subscribed, thank you very much. We are on our journey to 400 subscribers. Thank you very much. So without wasting so much time, let's begin with the requirements. First, you need a tapestry. You need some scissors. You need a crochet. You can also call it a latch hook. You also need a binding needle. Then you need a ruler. You need a thread. So the thread that I use needs to be chunky. In case you go to buy it, make sure you have that chunky. It's the thick one. This is the one that you need for making the mat, so that it is fluffy. Be fluffy, guys. I think that's the best term I can use. So let's begin with your tapestry. You can begin by binding the edge. When it comes to binding, you can use either binding needle. So the first step is making a knot. Knot, just the normal knot. So this is how you do it. Tie the normal knot. Ile ya kufunga lace is just the normal one. Hivo. Then I'm going to show you using the binding needle at first. So you fix it through the next hole after you make a knot. Then you pull it. So now I make something which looks like this. So you make it tight by pulling the other side. Then you pull this thread like this. That's the first step. Then you go to the next hole. Here you can hold it like this, no, at least it was simple to hook. So like this, you pull it, it comes through the next hole. Then, as I've told you, you pull the other side to make it tight. Then you're going to hook, because you can see I have two threads on the needle. Kuna hii na hii. From the first hole and from the second hole. So this time, I'm going to pull this thread that I'm hooking through both of them. So this is what I mean by pulling them through both of the holes. Through the first hole, through the second one. Then you continue. You hook, you pull it outwards. So I pull my thread through the first one and through the second one. So let me show you also how you can bind using the latch hook. So una fix through the next hole, just the way I've shown you. You hold it so that you can easily hook hooks. When I pull outwards, you can also see the two threads from the previous hole and from the current one that I've pulled out. So when I pull it, I'll make sure it passes through both of the threads heavy. Yeah, so let me redo it, this time not making a lot of noise. Heave. That has passed through the first, then through the next hole. As you can see, it has started making a pattern. Some rope pattern. This is how it looks like. This way. If you finish. So in ni moja nilikuwa nimesha tengeneza already. So that's the first step. The binding step. The next step is drawing a pattern. In case you want to make a mat that has a pattern. For example, I have this one that I made. Black and white. I used a ruler for my case. I used a ruler and a pen. So I'll be showing you using this one that I've already drawn. like it's a ruler that I used to partition it. Then I labeled B W B W. B for the black part, W for the white part. So that's how I managed to make this one. But bila kuchora, you can also make it. Na kuna zingi, you can also use the normal pen. And just like this one, it's 10 bob. So you can just draw. So use a pen or a mark pen, either way. So that's the next step that you needed to do. There are some patterns which are so complex. I'll pin a photo of one of the mats that I made. The pattern was so hard for me. So that is a trick that I was shown by my friend, and I'm going to show it to you guys. So the pattern, in case your pattern is too complex, you can have a piece of paper. For that, I prefer manila paper. Manila paper is the best. So you draw the kind of pattern that you want, let's say. In case you want to make something which looks like this on your mat, obviously it will be so complex to coordinate the threads to make such kind of a pattern. So you'll just draw it on a piece of paper or a manila. Make use of your scissors. Let me show you. So in case you want to make this kind of a pattern, you will come and place the paper or the manila where you want to draw the pattern. Let's say it's at this part, and then trace it out. Just trace it out. We are done with the part of drawing the pattern. So the next step that you need for making a mat, it's the cutting of the thread. That's where the ruler comes in. You will need your scissors and the thread. You will tie it on the ruler like that. Then use your scissors to cut them. So make sure they are really sharp. Mine is wearing out. It may go a bit loose. So you cut it. Even. So you get some threads of this side. This is the side that I prefer mostly. So zitakuwa zinatoshana hivi. Then you will pick your tapestry. The third step is fixing the threads onto your mat. Onto your tapestry. So I'll be using my latch hook. This is one of the simplest things. So you fold the thread into halves. I'll be fixing it through the first hole, it okay for the next. I hope you've seen what has happened. Then you open the hook. Then I fix my thread. I pull it this way. I pull it. Then I pass it through again. I hook. I pull it. But in case it becomes too loose, you can pull the threads apart. That makes it be a bit tight. So you fold from the first hole to the next one. Here, you can see you pull, you push it, you repeat it. You make sure that this small metal has passed the thread. Then I shall hook the thread, pull it. Then you can hold this part so that it doesn't come out. Then in case it's not tight. But let me show you a simple trick for making it a bit faster. Utapitisha hapa, it comes out through the next one. You fix, you pull. Simnaona sumishazoea mpaka hapo. So I'll just, when I hook the two threads that I'm holding with my fingers, nitaziachilia, then I tilt my latch hook, ikaivo. That's what I can show you about the making of the mats. So you shall just follow your pattern and make sure that you don't skip any hole. Like, ensure hakuna shimo umeruka, because if you jump any hole, I don't know, it's jump or man skip, your pattern will look funny. So from the other side you can see it. So that's how you make a shaggy mat. So I'll just show you some of the mats that I've made. I'll pin the others there at the end of the video. Then thank you guys, that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Give this video a thumbs up. In case there is something you have not understood, comment down below in the comment section. I'll clarify it for you. Yeah, I'll clarify everything for you. Then let's meet in the next video.